Yo, what's going on, y'all? It's Combo Breaker 99. I'm back with another video. Make sure y'all subscribe. All right, y'all, we got another quick add to the card on this Saturday coming up. You know, this hit me by surprise. You know, I was surprised that, you know, this was going to be a matchup. First, somebody told me that, check this out, they got another women's MMA fight coming up, you know, between two former Invicta fighters. So I was like, okay, I'll check into it. And I looked and I was like, oh, damn, they got, you know, Genufrey and Kay Hansen moving to the UFC. But lo and behold, I didn't know they were facing off against each other. I was like, oh, that's crazy, you know. And then it was like, no, it's happening this Saturday. I was like, oh, shit, okay. I was like, damn, that's pretty quick. And, you know, that's a pretty big shakeup. You know, I'm just saying as far as, like, especially for Genufrey, you know, who's a fighter who's fought at atomweight. And then you got Kay Hansen, you know, who's still pretty young in the game. You know, I want to say she's 19. I think she's pushing 20 right now. But, yeah, she's a young fighter. So, you know, this is a big step up for both fighters, but it's a good matchup. You know, I think this is going to be a good matchup for these two, you know, and kind of push forward and bring some more women, you know, to the forefront of the UFC and show you what they kind of been missing out on. Because, you know, both of these ladies came from Invicta, and, you know, when they were Invicta, they were, you know, putting on some good, exciting matchups, you know. So I'm a fan of both of these ladies, you know. Whenever Genufrey was the former atomweight champion, Kay Hansen, when she hit the scene, like 2017, the girl fought like five or six times. I want to say five times in 2018. You know, she was just like answering the call to fight. I think she fought like two Invicta cards, like back to back, like one in November, one in December, like back in 2018. Like she fought Erin Blanchfield. She fought a few other ladies. She came up short in that fight, but there was one fight too where she was just losing and she just came back with this, you know, badass submission. So I was just like, damn, you know, this girl's a fighter. And that's the thing you like, that's the thing you would like about fighters. Like, people can say Kay Hansen's green, but she's kind of like learning on the job. You know, she's actually willing to fight anybody, you know, to get her IQ up, to get her resume up. You know, she's willing to fight anybody. Like I said, she fought five times in 2018, like four times in 2019, and went 3-1 in 2019. So that, you know, that says a lot about her. You know, she's still young, but at the same time, she has the skill to just go in there and compete. You know, if it doesn't work out, she takes an L, she'll go back and work on some things. So, you know, she's a tough fighter. So this is a big, you know, this is going to be a big task for Genufrey, especially, you know, Genufrey fighting at 115 here, you know, because her being atomweight and moving up to fight somebody like Kay Hansen, you know, tough wrestler, you know, it's going to be a good matchup. You know, Genufrey, first off, in this fight, you know, she's definitely going to have to be, you know, on her striking. You know, she can't be too economical. You know, you have to be quick with the jab and use that hand speed. And since you're the lighter fighter, you know, you definitely want to use angles on Kay Hansen, you know, because Kay Hansen, when she starts, if you've seen some of her fights, when the bell rings, you know, she's rushing out at you. You know, she's coming straight at you, and she wants to take the fight to the ground. She has the hands. You know, I've seen, you know, she's had some boxing matches as well. I think she had like a boxing match on like a UFC fight card, I think, for Roy Jones once. But, you know, her thing is wrestling. You know, when she takes you to the ground, she's a wrestler, she's a grappler, and she's strong as hell. So, you know, she's definitely going to want to take somebody like Genufrey to the ground and keep this fight in a clinch fest, keeping Genufrey pinned to the fence. But it's going to be on Genufrey to use her hand speed, you know, use that jab against a wrestler, you know, jab the hell out, just use striking and keep it standing the whole fight. But I think this is going to be a good fight. You know, it's definitely going to be a good fight, like I said, for UFC fans, you know, that aren't familiar with Invicta fighters. You know, two of these two fighters from Invicta, you know, they're some of the best from Invicta. You know, they put on some of the best matches over there. So now people in UFC can actually witness, you know, what we've been seeing from Invicta. You know, I've been a fan of Invicta from, you know, the jump since it started, you know. So, yeah, they're definitely two ladies that, you know, I'm going to definitely look forward to seeing this fight. As far as a pick, damn, 50-50 on this fight. Only thing I can say is if Genufrey keeps it standing, I think the fight will favor her. You know, it has to be a striking match. But if Kay Hansen gets this fight to the ground, because I think Kay Hansen fought at like 125, you know, she's going to be the stronger fighter in this one. If she takes it to the ground, I'm gonna go with Kay Hansen. But like I said, standing, Genufrey. But I'm really 50-50 on this one. I'm just looking forward to a good fight. I gotta say, may the best fighter win on this one. I'll definitely do a post-fight reaction to this one. But I'm really can't really pick a winner on this. Like, I like both of them. So yeah, man, but definitely looking forward to this fight. Let me know in the comment section if you guys are. Combo Breaker 99. Make sure y'all subscribe. I'm out. Peace.